you want to take you inside.
And how does the Hollywood standard affect the rest of us?
We have patients asking for stars, noses, and lips and faces all the time. Beverly Hills is the mecca of plastic surgery.
The more celebrities turn to surgery, the more we are all drawn to their definition of perfection. Lasers, liposuction, Botox, they're all plastic procedures that became popular in the last decade. But celebrity surgery is nothing new inside Hollywood.
Well, there's a fine line between reconstructive and cosmetic. And, you know, for patients who've been in severe accidents or major cancer or had, you know, a significant portion of their face essentially taken off, we kind of coined it reconstructive.
After the war, stars could get expensive nose jobs or chin jobs, facial reconstructions for cosmetic reasons. A-list stars who make millions of dollars a movie hire teams of employees to protect their public image. And that means denial.
The worst part is when people deny it, and you're like, but your face didn't look like that like a month ago. So what happened? You go out in the wind too often?
They'll say, oh, you look great, you look youthful, what have you done, you know, to your skin, did you go on vacation? That's actually the look that I'm looking for.
Hollywood insiders say it's obvious when a star's appearance has been altered in some way. Botox, chemical peels, surgery, or just clean living. We may never know.
Well, if the stars have had great work, you and I probably will not know. I do pick up for the most part, but sometimes you can't. I mean, and that's a sign of actually good plastic surgery or good aesthetic enhancement.
Stars want the public to think they were born perfect.
You are paid to look perfect.
And really for a celebrity, I mean, how they look a lot of the times determines if they're getting paid for a job.
Just because a star denies that they've had surgery doesn't mean they haven't had something done.
The most popular procedures have definitely become the non-surgical, non-invasive procedures like injectables, Botox, Restylane, Radius. There's now a litany of products here in the U.S. that's available. They're being examined by their producers, directors, by their colleagues, and they're under a lot of pressure. And you know, when you look it back at a movie from the time you were 20 and now you're 40 years old, you start to, oh my God, look at how much I've changed.
Celebrity surgery is there to help a star's career inside Hollywood. But what happens when it all goes too far?
We see actors and actresses going too far all the time because the pressures that they're on, and they see themselves on camera so much, and they really examine their faces so much.
When a star goes too far, they sometimes have to have revisional surgery to undo the work.
Revisional facial plastic surgery has become such a huge area because there have been so many cases of famous people, as you know, that have had bad work that needed to, you know, fix their old plastic surgery issues.
American Pie cutie Tara Reid went public with her plastic surgery disasters.
There's so many individuals that are unhappy with a particular procedure that have been done. In my practice, about 75% of actually my practice is revisional work, believe it or not, which number one being revision rhinoplasty.
How do you tell a celebrity not to have plastic surgery if their lives depend on their looks?
We have patients asking for stars, noses, and lips and faces all the time. And I actually find it interesting, and I like it actually. And I would say Brad Pitt and Angelina, interestingly enough, are the two most common individuals that patients ask for.
The pressure to stay young is everywhere. That's why we'll always have celebrity surgery.